I'm just a humble repairing dude. With a humble repairing life. Why then are so many people obsessed with what I'm packing in my drawers? It's a tool time show and tell. Right now, Mark fixes stuff. This video is sponsored by PCBWay. You can get an instant quote on a variety of services, or browse a library of talented makers' designs, add them to your cart, and have them delivered directly to your door. I'm going to show you my top 13 tools, starting with a special runner-up, the Andenstar AD106S Digital Microscope. With my aging eyes, this little gadget has helped me find cracked joints, solder bridges and damaged tracks time and time again. In at 13 we have a digital oscilloscope. Oscopes draw a graph of signal changes over time, so show things that multimeters simply can't. I'm electric, baby! This is the first analog scope that I ever used, and it's working to this day. In at 12 we have the lazy fixer's dream. No more searching through boxes for the right DC power supply. I can use this DuraTool bench supply for DC circuits up to 18 volts. And as a bonus, I can limit the current the circuit can draw. Handy for troubleshooting your dodgy unit. At 11 it's a firm favourite, the Peak Atlas ESR70. This little wonder can check capacitance and relative resistance of capacitors, sometimes even in circuit. A real time saver when you're trying to find bad caps in retro machines. At 10 we have a large body of fluids. IPA for degreasing PCBs. Window cleaner for dirty cases. Liquid flux to aid soldering. Contact cleaner for sparkling sockets and pristine portholes. And acetone for extreme cleaning. At 9 we have buds, pads and cloths. When I'm wiping my bits and bobs, I always want these handy. Make sure you have your own stock of these so you don't upset the people you live with. For loose air. Two tools, one purpose at number 8, with a fibreglass pencil up first. A great item for cleaning connectors, scraping solder mask, or removing rust. Be warned that although useful, the fragments that break off are sharp like cactus needles, and you don't want them in your skin or eyes. There's also the wire pencil for bigger, harsher jobs. In at 7, it's an inexpensive but indispensable multi-bit screwdriver set. This one came from a budget supermarket chain, and has paid for itself many times over. Happy screwing! They say buy cheap, buy twice, but at number 6 I have several pairs of budget flush angle side cutters. Why so cheap and so many? Well, they have a magical ability to turn invisible when you're looking for them. Just ask Terry and Dave. I'm too old for extended screwing sessions, so I need a bit of battery-operated assistance when I'm on the job. At 5, it's a rechargeable electric screwdriver. Sure to save your wrist in manual sessions. Slipping in at 4, it's a hot double entry. a hot air rework station coupled with a flatbed hot plate. Setting this to about 120 degrees Celsius and popping a board on top means less hot air reworking stress and board warping than hot air alone. It also keeps tea hot. Not really. At 3, it's another pair of tools sliding into the same slot. First, it's the time-saving Tastic DuraTool desoldering station. Affectionately known as Moo Guns, this one has saved me countless hours on repairs. Plus, you feel like James Bond brandishing it. It's a hot tip, Miss Moneypenny. If manual pumping is more your jam, pump it up with the silicone-nozzled SS02 manual desoldering pump. The flexible tip is a highly temperature-resistant material and can get close to the hot solder action. Number 2 comes as no shock. It's a multimeter, and everybody needs this indispensable piece of kit. They don't need to be expensive to be useful. In fact, this budget model was a gift from my children, so it takes a treasured place upon my workbench. I can't imagine doing any repairs without a multimeter. Get one now. And finally, at number 1, it's a temperature-controlled soldering iron. Controlled means that more or less power is automatically applied to the iron to keep the tip temperature stable. I actually have two here. They're fairly inexpensive, and it means that I can have a large tip for big jobs like shielding, and a smaller tip for things like surface mount components without having to swap tip types mid-job. Bonus tip, wet sponges lower your tip temp and leave mineral deposits on your tool. I use a brass wire tip cleaner and find my tool is kept much cleaner. I hope you enjoyed this video. Since global events destroyed my livelihood, I've been striving to make my YouTube channel a full-time venture. If you could help, patronage of any amount helps me immensely. I'd like to say a massive thanks to my lovely Patreon supporters shown here on the screen. They make this channel possible and I am eternally grateful. You can join them at patreon.com/markfixesstuff. Thanks so much for watching this video. Here's some other videos you might enjoy. See you soon. Bye.